Hello everyone, and thanks for joining us again. This month we're going to share a lot of great and helpful information and let you know what's been happening here at El Paso Animal Services. But like we do every month, let's get started by taking a look at our live release rate for the last month. In March, we had a live release rate of 88.78%. Definitely a very busy month here at El Paso Animal Services, a month that even saw nearly 100 chihuahuas come into our care as part of a hoarding situation. Animal Services has been working hard to not only care and adopt these pups, but hundreds of others in our shelter. And besides caring for the pets that come into our facility, we're also reconnecting pets as well. In March, 296 pets were reunited with their families. 110 of those were even reunited without ever having to step a foot into the shelter, thanks to neighbors helping their neighbors. This is all part of our community and pet support program that is helping the community help their neighbors. Let's say your neighbor finds your lost pet. They connect with Animal Services to get the pet's photo on the website. And we also provide information and offer resources to the finder in hopes of reconnecting that lost pet back to you and putting that pet back in their home. Animal Services is seeing a lot of success with this found report process, with about 38% of the animals that go through this process returning home, compared to the 16 or 18% we have seen through the old traditional model of just catching them and bringing them immediately to the shelter. For more information on the found report process and our community and pet support program, visit us online at elpasoanimalservices.org and click on our found resources page. And speaking of our website, we've made some enhancements recently, all to help you and our pets in the community. Visitors can now search for a pet and filter their options through breed, size, age, and even provide their information if they want to be alerted whenever a specific type of animal enters our shelter. This is all in an effort to easily connect our pets with potential adopters in our community. Another enhancement that we made online is we put together a multimedia education page, all in an effort to make ourselves more accessible and provide education and information to families, teachers, everyone that wants to take a look on our webpage. This page provides all types of great activities and videos, from enrichment projects you could do at home. It's got story times, coloring pages for the kids, and even behind the scenes looks here at El Paso Animal Services. It's definitely our effort to try to connect the community with our department and really our effort to promote humane education in our community. Another resource we want to update the community about is our pet pantry program. Animal Services has given out tons of food this past year and in 2020, but the pet pantry has fallen on some hard times. A lot of that food has been given out to the community and we're running low on supplies. So we're asking the community if you could help out and donate to our pet pantry program, please do. Recently, we were very honored to receive a donation from the El Paso Veterinarian Medical Association that provided us with $5,000 so we could continue our pet pantry program. We hope to continue this program as supplies are available. So we encourage everyone, A, if you can donate, to please donate. And if you're in need of food and resources like our pet pantry, go ahead and visit us online. We have a pet resources page that will have all that information for you. Another update for one of our programs here at Animal Services is our animal protection team, our field operations team, that is out in the community helping pets in their neighborhood. The animal protection team is now back to pre-pandemic operations. They're now responding to various types of calls for service. Of course, the pandemic forced us to change some of our operations in order to make sure our staff remains safe. But now, as more and more of the community is vaccinated, our animal protection team is back out there responding to calls on a priority basis. The one change that will be kept is our found report process that we told you about, that we're seeing lots of success in pets returning back home. So if anyone were to find a lost pet that is friendly, healthy, and they're offering to hold that animal for a few hours or days, our field team will not be picking up those animals, but rather directing people to our community and pet support program to provide the best service we can to the community and that pet. And while I'm mentioning our APOs, we do want to let everyone know that this month we will be having an Animal Protection Officer Appreciation Week. It's a nationwide recognition and holiday for all our animal control and animal protection professionals out there. And here at Animal Services and in El Paso, we love our APOs. So if you see our APOs out in the community this month, thank them for their service. Or if you see them any other time, let them know that they're doing a good job and how much they are appreciated. This team works very hard to keep the public and our animals safe, and the hard work is just seen in all their day-to-day efforts that you see. As for adoptions, Animal Services will continue doing appointment-based adoptions, but we're also gonna be adding opportunities for folks to walk up right to the shelter and see our pets in our ABC kennels and offer some adoption processing all on the same day. For more information on when those times and availabilities will be posted or when you can come by, go ahead and visit us online on elpasoanimalservices.org and on our social media pages. Just search for El Paso Animal Services. Our goal is to continue to expand our appointments, but also expand our availability for walk-up adoptions. We have done several walk-up days so far and have a great response from the community, remaining safe and also getting our pets seen and adopted. Lastly, before we leave you, we want to let the community know that right now is the perfect time to vaccinate your pets for parvo and distemper. This is the time of year where those diseases and illnesses are starting to spring up, and we have definitely seen some cases in our community and that have even come off our trucks. We're encouraging the community, take care of your pets, get them vaccinated, because you want to keep them safe. There's always opportunities for those pets to come across these illnesses, and we want to make sure they're protected. Here at Animal Services, we vaccinate every pet upon intake, but there's nothing like having that pet vaccinated well before they ever need to enter a shelter or another situation where they might be out on the street. To find a list of veterinarians in our region, go ahead and visit our partners at epvma.org. They'll have a list of vet offices throughout the city. And go ahead and connect yourself with the veterinarian. Make sure that you take care of those pets and that they're seen by a vet each and every year. From all of us at El Paso Animal Services, we want to thank you for taking the time to view this episode and for being in touch with us. We want to remind everyone that when we work together, we will save more lives. Until then, see you next month.